Topic is hero turning zero, the refractory surprise. Mm-hmm. No financial interest. Refractive surprise can be predicted in high myo, high hypermetropic, HRK, BRK, and LASIK patient, unhealthy ocular surface, post vitrectomized eyes, post keratoplastic and irregular cornea, and pediatric cataract. Now, why did this happen? In the early morning, if you see an autoref paper like this, we get nightmare. What are the causes? Capsular distension syndrome, IOL malposition like tilt, sulcus, phimosis, biometry errors, entry or procedural error. If the person concerned is copying from the machine without printout, then there may be chance. And if you do a bad biometry, wrong biometry, then we'll have a definitely a refractive surprise. What are the options available? IOL exchange, piggyback IOL, cornea-based PRK and LASIK, treat the cause like YAC capsulotomy and IOL reposition. In the immediate postoperative period, recheck everything, including the IOL calculation in the pseudophakic mode. Check the preoperative data, IOL power calculation. Make sure the right person has the right lens and rule out the capsular distance. In the multifocal and monofocal lens, if it comes within 2 to 4 weeks, go for IOL exchange and piggyback IOL. And PRK is also another option in monofocals. If it comes late, go for piggyback lens, PRK oblique LASIK, or IOL exchange is not done to avoid compromise. Toric lens, very simple. If the IOL is rotated, then rotate back to its original position. If you have an exposure to the eye trace, it helps to know how much it has rotated and follow the instruction to realign to its desired axis. Or if you don't have anything, manually find the rotation in the slit lamp and take the help of astigmaticfix.com and correct to the new desired axis. I like to share a very small video. Here we put the input data, we put the IOL, desired refraction, the current refraction, uncorrected visual acuity, and we go for calculation. The website gives us the calculation and shows that if we do a 14 degree clockwise rotation, we get the desired result. Now, about the capsular distension syndrome, very common myopic shift due to the trapped visco behind the IOL. So there is a space between the posterior capsule and the posterior surface of the IOL, which can be confirmed by doing an anterior segment OCT. Now, what we done? Wait for a few days. If no result, go for YAC peripheral anterior capsule where there is no haptic. If the refractive surface resolved, it's very good. Other option, YAC of the posterior capsule, but definitely there is a chance of developing CME. And take the patient to the OT and do a visco wash. Prevention is thorough wash of OBD behind the IOL. A few words about the piggyback IOL. It's in sulcus IOL, inserted as an additional lens to the original IOL. It corrects the higher degree of refractive error, particularly hypermetropic, and suitable for cases with OSD diseases. Piggyback lenses are less accurate than the laser refractive surgery. Prerequisite for piggyback IOL, primary IOL in the capsular back, normal or deep anterior chamber, no glaucoma, pigment dispersion, normal corneal endothelial cell. Sulcoflex lens from the Rayner or the care group. How do you calculate for the piggyback IOL? Hypermetropic error, you got the spherical equivalent error into 1.5. In myopic, it is spherical equivalent into 1.2. And this is an photo of the piggyback IOL, 4-plate haptic. Now about the PRK and LASIK. Large range of refractive error, including astigmatism, can be corrected and should be done once the refraction is stable. Typically after 3 months, with caution in pre-existing ocular surface disease, such as dry eye, cost and access may be prohibited. But a proper counseling, meticulous biometry, a constant optimization, and IOL formula selection is the mainstay. We should remember an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. For high myope, issue could be low scleral rigidity and posterior staphyloma. Low sclerality can be avoided by doing an immersion technique and optical biometry, whereas in posterior staphyloma, immersion with the horizontal B scan and optical biometry. In the IOL power calculation, we go for SRKT formula, Holaday 1 and Holaday 2 and Hofer Q. Beret 2 Universal is a newly coming up online calculator. We can very well do it. We reserve the cases where the axial length is more than 30 millimeter. We go for Hegel's formula. For high hypermetropes, the issues can be corneal compression, smaller dimension eyes, less forgiving, and formula error. We can go for immersion and optical biometry. In the IOL power calculation, optimization is very important. Go for Hofer Q formula. Beret 2 Universal is coming up again in a big way. This is the choice of the day. Hegel's formula is used when the SE depth is less than 2.4 millimeter. For high hypermetropes, you should remember 1 millimeter difference in the axial length may lead to disparity even up to 5 diopter. And small shift in ELP may produce big surprise as the IOL is thick and close to the fovea. In the post-vitrectomized eyes, particularly in silicon field, ultrasonic biometry in the sitting posture and optical biometry in the silicon mode. Now, what about the optimization of the A constant? Is to refine the refractive error. The different input may be keratometry reading, axial length, IOL power and model, post-operative refraction. You can fit in the biometric machine or we can go for online like dynamic IOL optimization. Now, this optimization means change in the lens constant to reflect the surgeon's experience with a specific IOL. And this new A constant will take care of the small systemic error. For the specific formula, Holliday, surgeon factor, SLKT, A constant correction, Hofer Q, PACD correction. And after optimization, the result is 0.5 diopter defect within 70% cases and with 1 diopter defect in more than 90% cases. Take home points. Refractive surface are best prevented by the good biometry and the safe surgical practice and can easily be treated by the cornea and lens-based approach with a good outcome. Thank you so much.